It's Thursday, 20th September, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. After a marathon interrogation lasting over 7 hours on Wednesday, the police allowed Jalandhar Bishop Franco Mulakal, who's accused of raping a nun, to leave for the day with the interrogation set to continue today. Emerging from the high-tech interrogation cell at the Crime Branch office in Tripunithura, Kottayam Superintendent of Police Hari Shankar told the media that the first phase of interrogation was over and that the bishop was served notice to appear for a further investigation at the same place on Thursday. He said the bishop was cooperating with the interrogation but declined to divulge further details, including the bishop's defense against the allegations, on the ground that they were part of the ongoing investigation. Asked whether the police were able to have more clarity on the contradictions in the statements of the accused and the victim, Mr. Shankar said the investigation team would reflect on such matters once the interrogation was completely over. Taking forward the proposal to operate electric buses in the city, Transport Minister M.R. Vijay Bhaskar and Transport Secretary P.W.C. Davidar recently visited London to understand the way electric bus transport was being operated. A senior official of the State Transport Department said the trip to London was based on an invitation extended by delegates of the C40 Transport Group that visited Chennai last month. During the visit, Mr. Vijay Bhaskar visited the Transport for London TfL office and met Tom Cunnington, head of bus business development, who briefed him on the current status of the Clean Bus Initiative. The visit helped determine the broad foundation and arrangements that had to be made ahead of the introduction of electric buses in Chennai, a release said. In the near future, air passengers flying out of Chennai Airport may not have to stand in long queues at the entrance to get their tickets and ID proof checked to enter the terminal. Officials of the Airports Authority of India say the Digi Yatra scheme will soon be implemented by the Ministry of Civil Aviation. Under this scheme, a passenger going to the terminal can get his image captured and ticket scanned, after which she can enter instead of endlessly waiting in queues at the entrance. This system will save time for passengers and also ensure better security for airports. At first, on a trial basis, it will be implemented at a few airports including Kolkata, Varanasi, Vijayawada and Pune, after which we will bring it to Chennai as well, an official said. After the passenger's face is scanned, the system will know she has entered the terminal and subsequently, after the security check, instead of stamping by CISF staff, the machine will scan her face and with the boarding pass can go ahead for boarding. With this system, someone who travels with a fake ticket or with a boarding card of another passenger may not be able to do so and the system will find out immediately, he said. The government has approved a 65% hike and extended by 2 years a project to improve the stability and working of dams in 11 states. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, chaired by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, approved the Dam Rehabilitation Improvement Project or DRIP project on Wednesday. Out of the 3,466 crore cleared, 2,628 crore would be funded by the World Bank and 747 crore by the states and implementing agencies, and the balance 91 crore by the Central Water Commission. The DRIP project will improve the safety and operational performance of selected existing dams and mitigate risks to ensure safety of downstream population and property. The primary beneficiaries are both urban and rural communities dependent on reservoir and downstream communities who are prone to risk associated with dam failure or operational failure, said a press statement accompanying the decision. There are 198 existing dams in Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Jharkhand and Uttarakhand that would benefit from the project. The Commission of Inquiry looking into the death of Jayalalitha has written to the Chief Secretary and the Raj Bhavan asking them to provide more information on the former Chief Minister's hospitalization in 2016. Justice retired A. Arumugaswamy's letter sent on Tuesday to Chief Secretary Girija Vaidyanathan had four questions, while one sent to the additional Chief Secretary to the Governor R. Rajagopal had seven. He asked the Chief Secretary whether the five-member team of government doctors appointed by the government on September 30, 2016 to assist Apollo Hospital's medical personnel submitted a report to the government and, if not, why no action had been taken against the doctors. Meanwhile, Apollo Hospitals has informed the Commission that it is not in possession of the CCTV footage during the period of Jayalalitha's hospitalization. The hospital's September 11th letter was in response to a September 6th letter from the Commission to the Apollo Hospital's chairman, Dr. Pratap C. Reddy, asking his organization to submit the footage within 7 days. We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 85.43 rupees per litre and diesel for 78.12 rupees per litre. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 82.16 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.87 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 89.54 rupees per litre and diesel for 78.42 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 84.01 rupees per litre and diesel for 75.72 rupees per litre.